You know, when all this started, I felt like academic prep was not very good at what they do, and I still feel that way. Well, okay. They're actually very good at what they do. But you have to recognize that what they do is talk universities into giving them lots and lots of money. They are unbelievably good at that. The rest of it, the rest of the premises that they make, they're not very good at. But we knew that. We knew that when the smell of the partnership first blew onto campus. They're also really good at figuring out how to get us to pay multiple times for the same thing. So like, we split profits. So I would think that the half of the profits you get is for your systems, is for your agents. But we end up paying for all those things separately before the profits are split. So we pay a technology fee to the technology people that the corporate office uses. It has nothing to do with what we want or need. It's their MIS system that we have to use and pay, like a couple of grand every month. And then there is this new system that they're putting into admissions. And there'll be a monthly license fee for every user. We pay the agents, and then there's this 5% management fee that we give to them, all before any of the profits are split up. So it's been really very informative for me to see, oh, that is how you make money in business. You make people pay a couple of times for the same thing. I guess it's true that academic prep has to pay PBU for a few things too. They rent PBU rooms and maybe technology, so it could be that it goes both ways. Maybe the goal for both of them is to minimize the profits for tax purposes and just get as much as they can out of the black box of tuition before the profits are split and taxes get applied.